Well, hello, hello, folks, and welcome back to Banished. Let's just see if we got, we've got one student now. So, and hopefully very soon we'll get the, did I put that? Oh, it's right here. That last building supply, and then get the Farmers College built, and then we should hopefully be good for students for a long time. But so far this one will just take the ones that we get in the meantime. Let's see, I think we do have a few logs. We keep running out of logs. Well, first of all, to kind of, I should probably have done this a while ago, but let's see if we can find a spot where there isn't anything, so it just gets made immediately, like that. Just a little wood stockpile. So they don't have to run too far with it when they cut it down, because we don't have a lot of laborers, so that would be a little efficient. Then we have our foresters hub that we need to kind of get built. It won't, probably won't be too fast, because we only have two laborers and one building, but one builder, but we'll see what we can do. I was thinking there's, oh, where is it? Oh, it's not. It's right here. And the driftwood scavenger. I thought maybe we would pop this in. I was thinking about putting it over here, but I think it looks kind of strange, you know, it's not really, like following the river, kind of. I feel like most of the logs would probably just pass right by it. So, like, if we try to be a little bit realistic, so I thought this would be a good spot. I don't want it to stick out too far. I have no idea. I think maybe we're gonna have a trader coming too close, but we'll see. Preferably we would like to have it all the way out here, but I don't want to get too close to the traders. If it had been a lake, I would have been further out, but and I would probably see if I couldn't check the trader routes better than I have been doing so far in my let's plays. To kind of make it more realistic, but I think we're gonna pop that in right there, and we really need to get some roads in up here. Well, we'll just get see if we can do some temporary ones. We might move them, but well, move them at least, something like that. And have one go over here. They'll probably just, go that way, but maybe when the road is built, they will actually use it. Yeah, we need a road there, but we will get to it. We will get to it. So let's see, we do have a nice amount of stone, we do have some iron tools, and yeah, we are behind on coats as usual. Oh, that's right, I actually tried changing this to, survival coats, so that this one will only do leather hide coats. But I think we can't, I don't think we can keep up with the tools. Let's see, reduce 230, use 230. Yeah, because I switched the blacksmith over to doing iron tools instead of rough tools, and hopefully they'll last longer, so that might make the difference, but it does look like we're dropping a little bit, so I have to see if I can remember to keep an eye on that. We are actually getting some herbs stored now, that's nice. Food is still pretty low. Oh! I completely missed that. Oh no. I'm actually not sure if you can, I believe you have to kill all the animals, that you can't just move them to another pasture, but I'm not absolutely sure. Realistically, you shouldn't be able to, you would have to kill them. But I'm not sure how it works in Banished. I usually just like kill them all. That means we'll get some food at least, and then change it to a different type of animal. Yeah, probably I should build a couple more pastures somewhere, maybe, and then split them. So if we do get another infestation, then at least we still have some deer, just someone else or somewhere else, or we do have some freezing cows somewhere else. Though usually I just have one for each, because there are several different types of animals, but we might do some smaller ones. I think maybe we'll just do that for the freezing cows now. Just put in like a small one, so that we kind of have a few. Let's see. Maybe kind of. Let's see, dairy barn and the milking barn. Far out does this go? Yeah, we don't really want to encroach on that, but we could put like a small one here. We really need some more food storage or something over here. Yeah, we might put it there. Could also put the storage over here and then have like a small barn in the middle of the zone. But we also need more houses, I think. Building supply, and well, we do have houses there, we have houses here. Gonna put a few more houses there. We might put one kind of in. I think we're gonna put a few more houses here for this. Let's just see. Maybe we'll put in like a small pasture. If it gets too small, what do I have here? Alright, that's where we have the animal pens for the sheep. Oh, I keep forgetting. Oh, did I put it down? No. It's good. Just a little up one. Out one. So, if we put one in right here, just kind of a small one. I know, efficiency isn't what I focus on in general. So some of you are probably shaking your heads because, oh, that's a specific size that is the most efficient for like crop fields and everything. How much did we get from this? 101 kernels. So do they go in here, or do they actually go in the food storage? Or, well, this should count as food, yeah. Sunflower. Early winter, okay. Well, 101, that's not a lot. It doesn't feel like a lot, but that's the current season. Maybe we kind of put it down late in the season. I think we did. We'll check the next season. Driftwood scavenger. We only have one laborer and one builder, so just gonna pause that for now, but I would really like to put someone in there. Are we getting any building supplies? We have gotten one. So where are you? You haven't put it there. Oh, we got the domesticated animals. Now we have a wool pen also. Yay! Then we can get wool, and I do believe we get some. Do we get some leather or meat or something else from this? I can't even remember. Let's see. That creates wool and occasionally leather. Okay, well, that is cool. But we need people, for this. Okay, so that is done. So we must have just had some domesticated animals coming in. We do have one more bullpen, but I think I want them to put the domesticated animals on the milking farm now. Let's see. Okay, Farmers College. So, well, we don't really have paused everything, I think, that needs building supplies. So, where are you putting the building supplies? No idea. That's strange. Well, at least they're building this pasture for us, and our food went up a little bit. That should be because we were harvesting this, so we got some venison and some leather, that's good. Some bone meal. So, well, just gonna, well, we can might as well put this out of work because we don't have any animals. Well, we could put the freezing cows over there, but I don't want them that close, and I just want a smaller pasture for them, so kind of divide them and put some of them over here. If they are gonna finish this, where did I put that? Oh, down here. Okay, they just need to build it. And we had someone else die of old age. Yeah, okay. But we did just put all in all these houses in the last episode, so I don't really want to put in any more, even though we always need more houses. But yeah, 31 homes, 40 families. Because I do like to try to spread out the baby booms a little bit. We do have a couple of houses there we could finish building. And of course we're gonna need some houses in our foresters hub, which we are gonna start working on in a second. Just kinda want them to finish this. But we could see if there is a spot down here where we could kind of put stuff by the, just kind of down in this end of the map. Right there. And because we always need more wood, so and like that. And someone else died of old age. Okay. So how many students do we have? 6. Okay, so I really have to watch this. If someone else dies, we really need to change our builder to a laborer, because I don't really wanna lose the teacher. What are you out of? Wicks? We get lumber. How much lumber do we have? We might not need to produce any more just now. 156. Well, I think we're just gonna pause you for a little bit. And we have one more person there. Oh, the school is getting built. Yay! I don't really have any teacher to put in there, but we will eventually. We got a trader. Didn't even notice. Well, fill canteens. We don't really need those. Material warehouse. So where do we want the building supplies to go now? Or maybe they should just go there. To the material warehouse. So what are you out of? Well, it's probably the clay. Yeah, so it's a good idea to get the... Because it's getting moved away from there, and it's the only place to store materials. Otherwise they have to go... I don't even know where they store it at the moment. Well, maybe all the way over here. Material stockpile. Stone. Stone. Do have one right there. Got some furniture and lumber. Yeah, we need to get those material stockpiles in. Oh, we're running out of tools. So, we'll just... Oh, pausing. I knew I would forget to keep an eye on that. of students lacks an iron ore. That's just typical if you run out of those now again. It's one little. Don't really have any other trees close by that we can cut down. Did you cut down everything over here? Yeah, looks like it. 65, yeah, like I said. Ah! I knew I shouldn't have changed that around, but yeah. That's how it goes. Hopefully they'll catch up fast. And I think... no, that's not what I wanted. Also not that one. I think it's faster for this guy to do rough tools, so I think maybe we'll let him make some of those. Just to kind of catch up. How many people do I have here? Oh, and someone else died of old age. Yeah. Well, you won't be working right now. There we go. Okay, so we kind of just want them to cut down a few trees, just getting this standard pasture bulb, and then I think I'm gonna, well, I can leave the builder as a builder because he or she will work as a laborer, so it's okay. The reserve of logs is low, yeah, but it's higher than it's been for a while, so that's good. Just two more. Then this is ready. So we just need someone to grow up. And of course, because we have the school, it takes a longer time. So, yeah. That will slow things down. Let's see. A 9 year, 9 year old. 8, 8, 6, 8, 7. Seven-year-old child, why are you not in school? Don't they start as students in... let's see. Why are you not students? He should be from the age of 6 to 12, if I remember correctly. Where are our students then? Apothecary, Dredger, 500. Oh, someone became the Marcus. Were you one of these children? Let's just see. A whole 10-year-old student. 10-year-old. Okay, so it's when they're 10. Oh right, I don't have the 1 year is 1 year mod. That's the problem with playing two different games. Ah, right. Okay, so it's from the age of 10 to 16. Yeah, I forgot that. Making myself completely confused. Okay. Oh, 246 logs. That's good now. And we are catching up with the tools, it looks like. So that's good. Phew. Food. Well, we are still hanging in there. Let's just see. Food, food, food. Well, they're producing 10,500. We use 9,500, so that's 1,000 in plus. But it's not really going up, so. Yeah. Looks like we're struggling a little bit at the moment. Let's just see. I don't really want any more fisheries here. And yeah, I know this guy is gonna kind of, well, he's actually kind of right outside the sphere of influence or whatever you would call it. So that's pretty nicely placed. Well, we could put in a couple of show houses to catch some frogs. How much do we get from this? 264 turtles for two people. Yeah, we really don't get a lot compared to fishing. Fishing is very overpowered, so. And this guy, yeah, 320. That's actually not bad. It's for one person, so it's not too bad. It's actually better than the show houses and the scavengers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 500. Oh, our food is going up. That's good now. Plus we are housing. How much did we get from this now? 207. It's not like we're getting a lot of these ones, huh? Edibles need to. So where did you store them? I don't know. Well, we have a trader. Oh, bisons. Okay, well, we might buy those, or we could buy chickens. We actually kind of need chickens. So we can get some eggs, and then we can get our chicken breeders going when we get some more people. I think maybe that's what we're gonna do. Let's just see. But I would kind of like to have something bigger here, so maybe we'll wait before we kind of divide these or make another pasture somewhere. So. But I need to. Okay, pause. I need to take someone off something because I don't really have anyone to work. Well, we might make do with one person here actually because it's not really a huge pasture. So I think maybe I'll try that. And then change this to chickens. Yeah, I think we're gonna do that. Then we could buy some bison and put in there. Do we have someone else we could kind of take off something? Yeah, anything we don't really need. Well, we caught up with tools, so we could kind of pop this down to one, I think. I think it's good if we have one there and the blacksmith working. And I think we're gonna switch you back to iron tools. So what else do we have? Outreach. Fuel limit. Well, we want you to keep making fire bundles, so I'm just gonna pop that up to 2000. So what else do we have? Fragmenta. Yeah, because you're using up all the fire bundles, and then we're not gonna get any furnace fuel if we don't have any of this. So yeah, that's why you're complaining you don't have any furnace fuel. So that's good, we got that fixed. So even though we do have plenty of iron for now, so that's not a big problem. Small iron melter, with one person there. Well, we could pull someone off this. For a bit. Yeah, I think we're gonna do that. I guess we could really use them elsewhere. Okay, so let's see. We are gonna buy some chickens. Don't have any native artifacts, so how much do we actually have? Okay. Take all the firewood, and we have 16 bows, 20 furniture, 2600. Okay, so we start with 2 chickens and 2 bisons. How much is that? 2400. If you buy one more chicken and... Oh no, not one more. Not one. Oh, the saving. Three chickens, of course. And then we sell 200 wheats. 28. Then we have three chickens and two bisons. That's enough that we can let them have babies. And lots of eggs. Yeah. Trade. Dismissed. So, what did I say? We want some... where's this one? That's this one. We do want some chickens on here. And we're gonna put one person in there. And yeah. And we'll get a lot of feathers so we can get some more survival codes. So that's really good too. And then we are changing these to bisons. Put one person in there. And... hello. Why does it say out of work? 1, 2, and the chicken, 3. So 1 of 1, 0 of 1. Still here, see it. 1 of 1. What am I missing? Oh, yeah. That's what I was missing. There we go. Okay. We can have 12 bisons there. How are we going? 8, 12, okay. Yeah. Yeah. Welcome to our little town. Yeah. There they go. There they go. Off to your pastures. You are running over there and you are going for a swim. Yeah. 1, 2. Where did the third one go? Oh, it's because I think it's because there's two on top of each other. We're taking the long way around. We could just have taken the bridge. Oh, it's all the way over here. Then that would be perfect. Yeah, you're coming now. That's good. Oh, look at that. And you can't figure out how to get through the gate. Well, hopefully eventually you will. Oh, did we have more babies over here? Oh, look at that. Oh, it's so cute. Look at that tiny one right there. Yeah, we have 9. We have a newborn. Aww. Oh, little cutie. Yeah, I'm sad. We're gonna eat you eventually. But hopefully you will bring us a lot of milk before that. How much are we actually producing? 400 milk. Yeah, and then in a year or two we'll probably be getting some meat and some leather from this. I know I could just put it down to something lower so they'll start butchering them, but not for now. But I will be putting in another pasture, of course, eventually. So look at this, we have 3 of 22, and we're already getting some eggs, so our... let's see, I have one. Did I leave it up? Oh, I think it's right there. So this should be getting built soon. And again, we're down to someone died of old age. Okay. So this is gonna, so we need a lot of people. Is it just me? It's year 30. We haven't had any nomads yet, have we? I can't remember. Maybe you don't get nomads with this. I think you don't. Yeah, I don't think I ever got one in the Mega Mod Let's Play, so... I would have to put in something else, but we don't have a lot of food, so I'm not really interested in getting any nomads, and... it seems to always kind of just mess up the game for me. So, yeah. Okay, so are you getting... no, you're not getting any fire bundles. Fire bundles. You're not producing... oh. Okay, I think it's because I used all this firewood over here. So... they... Are you using a lot of fire bundles for fuel in the houses, probably? Okay. How many people do we have here? We could put in one more when we have some more people. The reserve of logs is low. Well, it's at 100, so that's pretty nice actually. We could cut down more. We do have some logs there, so... Looks like you cut down most of what was out here. There you go. And... just gonna see. Yeah. They are hard at work. Okay, yeah. So... well, then we don't really... want to cut down all those trees. Cancel removal. Okay. And I'm gonna go over here. And kind of in that area. Just give you a lot to do. There we go. Wow, I wonder if I ever get around to this Foresters Hub in this episode. Ooh. Seeds. Did they fill up anything? It did fill up a little bit. Silk cocoons, tinware pieces, tobacco, white mulberry. Can we make one of those? What is it called? Production. Oh, there we go. Yeah. Silk one pot, so then we need the. Might be sit out here. Old castle, old buildings. White mulberry grow. That might be a good thing to get those seeds. I guess they also produce, well, I don't know if they only produce leaves. Okay, probably if you I guess when you I didn't even pay attention to that in the other game, but in my other Let's Play I already have one of some of these. But I guess when you plant these then you actually get white mulberry. Like as a food, I would imagine. And then you can use the white mulberry to plant the white mulberry grove, and that's where you get the mulberry leaves that you then use for the silkworm huts, so that they can produce some silk. So it is, should be a food, I'm thinking. So that might be a good idea. Then it's like we both get some food and eventually we can build that. 3000, do we have that much? I really need to put more stuff in here, I think. That's 2000. Oh, I don't think we have enough. 5. Yeah, we don't. 24. 300. 2790. Okay, well, What do we have? Quantity? Strikes, firewood. Well, I don't really want to put any more firewood at the moment because we're not producing that much and we are struggling with logs as usual. We do have some candles, we could sell a few of those. We need some to upgrade some. Did I ever tell them to upgrade this? Oh, that's not yet. Oh, yeah, we did upgrade it, okay. But can we upgrade this one? Yeah, we need candles. Oh, it's only 6%, so that's kind of soon. We need to upgrade that, so we do need some candles for that. We have a lot of furniture, so we could sell some of that. Let's see, 182. Like 80 furniture, maybe? Should we see? I have no idea what candles are worth, but maybe put in 40 of those. Don't want to sell any of our basic resources like stone and iron ore. Could put in a few more reeds. 500. I try to mostly use those as like in an emergency, or kind of because they're only worth one, then you can kind of get the numbers to add up. But we do have a lot of them, so but I know how easily you can run out of them when you're making fire bundles and survival codes, and if we start making ropes using those too. Okay, we don't really have a lot of other stuff. Well, we could probably start selling some survival codes if we get a lot of chickens going, because then we get a lot of feathers and we do have a lot of weeds coming in. That might be an option. Yeah, I think that might be an option. Okay, 31 homes, 38 families. Okay, that's probably because someone died off. So we are only 7 homes behind at the moment. Okay. So tools are going up. I'm still struggling with clothes. Yeah, I know. So, let's see. See if they're gonna fill up some of this. Oh, candles are worth 8. That's not bad, actually. 21. Oh, and we got a lot of furniture. Wow, they can carry a lot at once. It just popped up. Okay. There we go. So. I think this is the one we want to take down. That's 25, 35, 465. That's in too much. 460. Then we need 10. Let's sell one candle. And 2 reeds. There we go. Then we get some wild mulberry seeds. That's good. Trade. Let's miss. Okay. Well, somehow I actually kind of like that we're not getting that many domesticated animals, because in the Mega Mod I get so many of them, I don't need to trade anything else. I can just because I have, I think I have 2, 3, maybe 3 foresters hubs in that, but I just got so many from the beginning, so I could build a ton of these if I wanted. The animal pens, and I could build the milking barn, no problem, and I could just put I have 250 in each of my trading posts, and they always just fill them up if I use a lot of them. And it's really overpowered. So I kind of like that I don't get that many. Eventually, of course, they'll start adding up when I don't build a lot of this. But it just feels very, very overpowered in the Mega Mod. I'm not really sure why they made it like that. It might just be something they haven't noticed when they try to balance it. But I just feel like it's very overpowered. And here I actually have to think about what I want to buy. In the other one I'm like, okay, I want 10 different... I have like a farming supplier. As a trader, so he brings in like 10 different kinds of seeds, and I can just buy all of them at once because I have domesticated animals, you know. So, what's the big deal? Hey! And yeah, I have to struggle and see if I can find something. I know it's still early in the game, but I like the way it kind of slows things down a little. Of course, I can choose to not use them in the other game, but we are so far into the game, so it just feels kind of, redundant to start playing around with that, and I just have the animals laying around, but I don't know, I might do another Mega Mod series at some point, and then kind of, unless they change it or balance it. I've been told that they did try and rebalance it, but I haven't really seen. It should be updated, my mod. Well, not to the one they have, I think they have a newer version maybe at their own homepage, and mine is from Steam, so that might be why it's not been updated. But if they don't like balance it more like this, then I might do another Mega Mod series and then kind of give myself that channels that I can't use the domesticated animals for trading. And then I can only use them, which is even very overpowered because you have so many of them, so you can build these like more or less on your first day. The second you start clearing some forest and get a forester in, then you can kind of put in quite a few of these animal pens, and then you're kind of set, you know. But at least say I can't trade with them, that might be something, but we'll see. Is our tools going down again? Go check. Production. Tools. We are producing more. Yeah, it should be going up. Food. Yeah, we're still struggling for food. Did you have any babies yet? No. Are you producing anything? No. I guess we only get meat and leathers from those. And oh, look at that, we have another baby. Another little one. Oh. And a lot of milk. Yeah, that's really good. Okay, well, let's see. We are actually getting close to the time where we are supposed to end this episode, and I still haven't gotten any of this done, and we're still missing some more people. Oh, what happened? Why do we... Oh, okay, yeah. Just gonna pop this down and tell them to upgrade this. There we go. But that means we have more people now, so... Why do I want to put someone in? Of course we're gonna need them here too, but we do... I think we do have a lot of ammo. So it may not be that we have to bury so much with that. 372... Yeah, I think we're good for a little while. Hopefully we get some more people. So I think maybe the Driftwood Scavenger would be a good thing. So that we can... Kind of, I'll just put one person in there for now. And oh, we need some kind of storage here. I think eventually we'll put in some wood storage building, but for now we're just gonna pop down. Let's just see. There we go, wood stockpile. Well, actually, I think there's one in the dock set. Let's just see. It's probably in this one. Dark wood storage. Yeah. That might be something. Well, you can't really walk off there because there's no white kind of attachment. Where do I want this? Could put it like this. Kind of right there. And slip going right up to it. Did I leave a gap? Let's just check. Yeah, I did leave a gap. So he has two wood storages, that might be great. Okay. Just gonna pause one of them. And then they will eventually build that one. Okay. And just for so he doesn't have to run too far with it until they get it built, just make a little wood stuff out right there. Yes, so there we go. A merchant again. Chili oil, cheese bread, meat, and hardtack. Well, it might not be a bad deal to buy a little bit of food. Just to kind of carry us over. 999. Then of these, that's 800. And some candles. 20? No. 90 maybe. Okay. 20, that's 80. 2. Need 4. One piece of 5. Oh no, that's 3 we need. Okay. I can't even calculate anything, count anything. Oh, it's 399. What am I thinking? Hello. Okay. Let's see, 22. That's 150. That's too many. It's off. What are we off on? It's many. 40. Yeah, okay, so we need 100. Nine, 87, and we need 12. Oh, one of those, five of those, 11. Yeah. Wow. Okay, the reserve of iron is low. Wow, that's going down fast. I'm getting some furnace fuel. Apparently not fast enough. I have bundles of fuel is going down. Where is our? Right there. How much are you producing? 303 firewood. Okay. Finish fuel. Looks like it's a fire bundler that's struggling a bit, so hoping one more person there. See if that can help a little. Okay, how many people? Oh, we have 7 more people now. Wow. Okay. And did I put anyone to work here? No. So I think we're just gonna pop someone in there. And we do have. I think we're just gonna build these two. Not gonna put them to work, but we can get more food. Oh, we already have 10 chickens now, and lots of eggs, that's good. And 7 and 2, how many students? 12 students. So, no. Maybe we should put someone in here. Work. There we go, Farmers College. And if I remember correctly, we can have 80 students in this one, so that's a huge building. What else? Well, it might be a good idea to get the wool pen started too, also, actually. There we go. Because then we'll get wool and some extra leather. From that, so I am thinking you might as well start making wool coats. Yeah. And should probably think about soon putting in another blacksmith somewhere, and then we can. Well, I could put in one more of these duckweed chips to kind of make survival coats for trading. That might be a thing. And then eventually I can change this over to either making fire bundles or some rope. When we get the other fire blacksmith in. Yeah, I think we may do that. We may do that. That is the duck workshop. On the right next to you. Right there. Yeah. Okay. And the material warehouse is getting built. That's good. That must be this one. Yeah. So, now. Showman doesn't have to run too far with his clay because he can just pop it right in there. Well, he does have material stuff and he's. So, how come our quick sky. Oh, it's the furnace fuel. Okay, I thought it was the clay he was missing, but it's actually furnace fuel he was missing.
Okay.
And yeah, we got some chicken breeders, but for now, just forcing you. Okay, so what else do we have? That takes material warehouse, food storage. I think I'm just gonna take these off first, so whatever building supplies we get, they will get built. For now, anyway. Did we get any domesticated animals? No, it's the only one. Okay. Oh, we have 8 laborers now. Okay, things are picking up now. That's good. So, okay, is our channel... Well, we don't really have a lot of lumber now, so that might be good to start producing a little more of that. Though we are struggling with luck, so... No, just gonna wait. Just gonna wait. Okay. How's this mine? 41%. I'm not doing anything in the precious one. And you're almost finished with this one. Okay, well, then we need people from that. 1, 2, 3. And yeah, we want some iron ore. And then we're gonna need to put in another one for some coal, I think, eventually. Maybe we'll do the tunnel mine. That produces both stone, iron, and coal. If we have that in this mod, I'm not quite sure. But yeah, before I keep going, I think it's time to end this episode. So let's see. Oh, we got another bison. Another tiny one. Maybe they just start out as big ones, unfortunately. Oh, look at those. They're so cute. They're so cute. So yeah, okay, you're gonna start, yeah. 160 beef, 5 leather, 3 bone meal. I feel so bad that we're gonna butcher you guys because you're so cute. Yeah, you're so cute. Oh, they don't even grow up like immediately from the stage. Look at that. That one is smaller than that one. So they have several stages. Oh, how cute is that? Look at that. Oh, so we have a calf and then kind of a young one there and like a teenage cow. Oh, so cute. Yeah. Okay, well, I'll try and stop gushing over this. And then, thank you very much for watching, guys. I hope you're still tagging along. I really enjoy reading your comments and replying to them. It really makes me happy that someone is watching and making some suggestions and giving me information. You're very good at that, and yeah, just kind of enjoying the series with me. That means a great deal. So take care, everyone, and I hope to see you in the next episode. Bye.